Welcome everyone, this is my college, Morningside College, and it's one of the most modern college in the Chinese University of Hong Kong. It has really good facilities, good dorm infrastructure, and today I'm going to show you some of those good things to look at. So let us first look at the college patio, which we are going towards. Well, before that, these are the two buildings. This is the T block and the G block. T block is, as you can see, much larger than the G block. And this is usually where most of the freshmen live. This is for the seniors. Here we have the NC cafe and some of the important things like music room and stuff like that. Both the buildings are joined by this common bridge where you can just chill, hang out, meet with your friends or whatever. So yes, this is the Morris R. Greenberg building, which is the G block. Okay, well, here are some of the recycling bins. So in MC, every floor has a recycling ambassador. We recycle our garbage and we put it here. So isn't it cool? Yeah. Let's go ahead. And this is basically the college patio where we can just see the sunset, sunrise. It's really good to see all the buildings and the lighting that is there at night. This is the way to the college canteen, where you can get some good food if you want to. Here the communals as well, they happen. These are some of the rooms where our college classes like GEMC and like some college course happen in these rooms. They're also pretty cool to look at. So let us first have a look in the canteen. So it's the Easter holiday, that's why you cannot really see many people all around, but guys, believe me, MC is not that small a college. It has around 300 people, which mean a lot. And yeah. So usually that way it goes to the warden's house, and you are not supposed to go there, but okay, let's see how much we can. Okay. So guys, now I will show you the patio, which is a very beautiful place in the college. There you can see the sunrise, sunset, and like lots of lighting. It's
And you can see Yash.
Yes, and you can see this random guy who is not from Morningside. Anyway, see, Morningside is very welcoming. You can just get visitors anytime you want to. Just beware to let them go by 12 midnight. So there are lots of benches, lighting everywhere, so just don't be afraid to come to the patio anytime. Okay, so as you see right there, like there are certain places to just sit, relax, drink with your friends and stuff. And so guys, 1, 2, and 3, and this is the wonderful view I was talking about. I mean, just imagine you're having a busy day, you're having your exams, you need some kind of like a refreshing exercise for your brain. You just come here, sit down and have some chill in your life. And yeah, that's all. I won't speak much to destroy the silence of the place, because I feel silence is a pleasure in itself. Okay, so guys, you see there, these are where our tutors live, who teach us the very, very, I wouldn't say GEMC course. And on the top of this building, you see that house on the 11th floor, that is where the warden lives. It's the most expensive house in this entire college, with a roof. And you can see the same view with a lot more pleasure from there. Now let's go inside the building and check out some of the various cool items in the college. Okay, so let's start with going into the MC cafe. The way is a bit creepy, but it's not. you usually have to tap the card to get in anywhere inside any building in Morningside.
Yeah.
And here are like some of the photo displays. Like there were some photo competitions. So such competitions, they keep on happening very frequently in MC. Like that's one of the best point of it. Being an international college, there are lots of events to help people bond together. And just ignore these some crap rooms in between, there are some storehouses. Well, this is the much famous NC Cafe because it attracts lots of people, it has lots of good snacks to take. However, due to Easter it's closed today, but you can usually find some brownies, cookies, some toasts and those kind of things here. This is again a place where people usually study, eat, chill and talk. So here people just study at night or like they chill, they talk, they have food in front of them. So yeah, like you have to be a bit cautious about your money because when you sit here and you see good food, you just tend to tap your card again and again. Okay, so this was all about the NC Cafe. Now let's move ahead to TV room. So anybody seeing this video, don't think you can come here, okay? You can just chill. So usually you can see such boards everywhere, but to be honest, if you have the right person with you, you can just get into anywhere. Just remember to get by 12 midnight. Okay, so this is the TV room.
What happens if you don't get by 12 midnight?
Usually if the person catches you, then you will be fined. But it's not that strict. You might be just left like that as well. Okay, so this is the TV room. Here, many a times, the tutors of the GEMC course, they watch some kind of movie around every Wednesday, and you're always feel free to join them. They will give you a free flow of wine and stuff like that. So it's a really cool place to hang out and chill. And these are certain books. Here, we can see some DVDs and like stuff kept in, though it's not right now, but usually it's present. It's just empty today. And yeah, this is the cool thing. I mean, can you guess what is it?
Alcohol?
Yeah.
Really? What is it?
Just kidding, it's just water.
Okay.
Okay.
MC doesn't have alcohol everywhere. Okay.
They have.
Oh no.
But that's not to be shown on the camera.
Okay.
And everywhere, this is the ordinary bell that you have to ring to get out. Even I am seeing this for the first time. Please enjoy these books. Okay. Maybe they are not so great, that's why I kept them.
That's the guy who came there to see you talk.
Yes. So guys, this is the place where most of the seniors live. And trust me, it's not that good. It's a really isolated place to live in. Better building is this where I live, so let's go inside this. And you enter the best place to live in Seoul. Okay, so these are some of the lockers. And yeah, MC people are really rich. They have to store their diamonds and gold somewhere. So this is that place. This is the charging payment kiosk to charge your AC, laundry. It's a machine which will take away all your money, trust me. Now, if you enter this door, you can see the vending machine. Let me show you. Let's come inside. Okay, and to be honest, this is also a really scary place. The machine is really expensive, but some of the snacks are worth it, so it's up to you. And yes, you just tap the number of whatever thing you want, like 303, and then you just tap your card here, and it comes out to you. beware, sometimes it gets stuck in between, like you can see this weird spiral going nowhere, but even the bestest place on the earth has some flaws, so it's fine.
The best place on earth.
Okay, now let's proceed to the college office, which is a place from where the entire Morningside College is regulated. Any complaint you have or any problem you have in living in Morningside, you just report to the college and they are really very proactive in helping you. Okay, so before that, I will also show you a small replica structure of Morningside, which will help you understand what this college is about, because it's relatively a small college as compared to other colleges in the field. But yes, it is what it is. So this is the model, and I think it's complete model to understand itself. Like, this is the university sports center, which you can see here, and this is the Morningside College. This was the patio we were just at, the beautiful place. Okay, so this is the college office. This building is really important and they are all really helpful. Any problem you have regarding anything, scholarship, finance support, or some study related help, academic advice, any issue in the communal dining, any food, any problem, you just come to this door, they will help. Now, let's go to the bridge, which is the connecting link between the G block and the T block. Yeah, so guys, don't think that there are so many stairs. Actually, we have avoided the lift to show you guys the real side of Morningside. So don't worry, you will not have to walk much. So, let me first show you the laundry room. Maybe that's also important. So here is basically the corridor to access the laundry room. It's not just laundry, it's also dryer and spinner. It's up to you, whatever you want to use. And here basically all the aunties are like on the shelf. Okay, so this is the laundry and these are some of the machines. You just put your clothes, charge the money, that's the dryer, that's the spinner. This is the place to hang your clothes. Beware, you have to be at time, else people like take out your clothes and put them on floor and blah blah blah. Anyway, these are the sinks and like detergent place, and like you can just wash and like do whatever you want to basically. And yeah, like personally it's like my hangout place because I like that smell of the detergent.
Smells amazing.
Yeah.
Studying here?
Yes. I can.
Really?
Ah. Like usually you have to reach on time. So like if you are before, you just take a chair and you sit in front of the dryer, because there are just two dryers for 300 people, so you can imagine the pressure on them. Let's proceed to the bridge. So again, like this machine, this card, remember, very important. So this is the basic bridge. It connects the G block and the T block. And this is the computer room we have here. It's really cool because it's like the best place to study, really comfortable, and like it just sets your mood right. This is the tuck shop, which is owned and governed by the MCSU, the student council, and they're also really proactive. This opens daily at 8:30 till 11:59. Things are pretty cheap here as compared to that vending machine down, so come here, not there. This is the building that goes to the T block. Like, it's not dark, it's like some light sensors. Like, they will just sense your motion and they will get activated. So let me first show you the study room.
And you can get in there if you don't want the cardboard?
Yes,
okay.
With this card.
Do I need to
go
to the window?
No.
Okay, sorry.
Okay, so this is the study room, the computer room also. These are the two names which we call this. And as you can see, like, it's so comfortable. It just gives you the vibe to study. And here are like large windows you can just open. It's up to you. You want to set the AC temperature. Everything is in your control here. That's the printing machine, scanning, photocopying, everything in that machine. Just insert your card, put your pen drive, and guys, print anything that you want to. So it's a very self-sufficient place. You don't need to run here and there for various things. And let us go to the gym. Just opened it. So I would say the gym is pretty small, but it's okay for beginners. I mean, you have certain amount of weights. I think till 20 kg maximum. I know that's pretty less, but it's okay. And yeah, these are some of the machines you can just use, build your body and become a morning side. Yeah. So yeah, I hope you know this machine. You run, run, run. And this is the table tennis. Not much to show in this gym, but it's pretty good.
Yeah.
I don't know why they have kept so many Bisleries here. I mean, like, are we just supposed to open it and drink? I have no idea, guys. But yeah, it is what it is. These are some of the yoga mats. And yeah.
College provides yoga mats?
Not really, but they are kept here if you want to use. Not officially, but yeah, you can use it. So this is some kind of a dress code which nobody follows. I don't know. You know, like every college has some kind of random things which are just to show. Yeah. That's one of them.
Have some people hang out in this gym too, I guess.
Yeah, they do, they do. Every night you can just, if you want to have some fun time, just come to gym. There'll be random people playing ping pong and stuff. Just join them and you'll be happy. Yeah. Okay, so let's go to one of the floors and explore pantry and stuff. Okay, so now we use the lift, and I will also show you the lift inside morning. Don't show this. I will also show you the lift inside this. So another disadvantage of T-block is that lift breaks down very frequently. And imagine going down from the 10th floor to the ground floor using stairs. It takes effort, guys. Okay, a well-renovated lift. And I'll take you to my floor. I'll also show you some of my rooms. So let's enter the third floor. This is basically, most of the internationals, they live on this floor. Second floor is mostly for locals. Yeah, this is basically the introduction of what kind of people live here. You can just see all kind of abuse and stuff. Like, you can see how multicultural. You can see Burmese, Hindi, Nepali, English. I don't know even what all languages are there. Yeah. Among us. Okay, so like this is my room. Yeah, you can see how patriotic I am to this nation. And just sorry, it's very messy, but it's okay. Yeah. There are some windows, not so ventilation here. That's the AC, and like you have to pay a lot for it. Yeah, a small fan. Yes, so the problem is even the windows don't open much. So the room is like, the room kinda sucks, but the best thing is about the personal fridge that we have, because like
most colleges don't.
Yes. And like still people like keep their food outside and get stolen and then blame the college authority, but I think you should all use this. And yeah, like these are the cabinets. I think space wise to store your luggage is pretty good, because you have this, you have the shelf, you also have a drawer underneath in which you can just keep your stuff. Like, I just filled it with food, so I have nothing to show. Yeah.
Okay.
And okay, let's go. Okay, so this is basically a very important door. Like, I will just block you. It's like, usually people make a lot of noise in the pantry and like stuff at night, so you can just restrict the doors and then just close it open. Guys, you can see the second floor from here. So usually the second and the third floor, they are connected, and the fourth floor is for girls, so that's like separated. And here is the college pantry. You have got two fridges which are like absolutely full. Even though you have personal fridges, I don't know what people keep so much. I'm a vegetarian, so I don't have to store much. Well, I was just cooking something, so it's like my mess which I'll clean, right? Yeah. And you can have a look at that patio again. The tennis court, and like the view is just fabulous. I'll show it from other side as well. So yeah, so here like everyone can just store some of their utensils, and like it's like space wise there is no problem to store things in NC. So just get whatever amount of stuff you want to. This is the water boiler, microwave, baking machine, everything you have. And guys, this is the thing I was talking about. the recycling, which is on every floor. Very important, you have to segregate your waste because we are the future of tomorrow, right? Yeah. So, blah, 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 blah. This is the generosity box. Trust me, nobody is generous enough to keep anything. You can just see what kind of things are there in the generosity box.
There. Yeah. Thanks.
However, on the fourth floor, which is the girls' floor, a lot of things are like food items and stuff are kept. I think they are more generous or something.
So depends on how generous you are.
Yeah, and one more, most important. So much stealing of food happens. Like people have to literally abuse the person. Like recently and like every time. Stealing is very common, guys. Just use the personal fridge. I don't know why people do. Okay, so these are some crap rooms. Like, just don't focus on them. This is the corridor. Somehow the light is not working. I don't know why. It has always been like that. Well, some people are like extra sporty. So, okay, so this is the corridor. And like, we have some places to study in like every room, apart from the computer room. So this is like such a place.
Every floor.
Yes, every floor, and like it's air conditioned and like stuff. So let's enter this one. So usually it's like pretty small, but it's like good, a private place to study quietly, and like you have your own people living on the floor, so like you don't feel uncomfortable like the U line. And the best thing is again the wonderful views which we get in Morningside from everywhere. If you are just tired, you just come here, stand for 5 minutes, the energy you will get is unmatched, guys. Yeah, so like, I mean like, I have nothing to say about this, you just see and enjoy. In fact, my PE class, it happens there. So I just come here in the morning, see if there are many people gathering there, then I just quickly run to my PE, otherwise I don't go early. So lots of perks to come here.
Until I found someone who laughs like you.
Okay, I won't show you inside, but like, this is the place to pee. And like, usually this is the disabled washroom, but since we don't have any disabled person, so if there are some girls who come on this floor, they use this. If there are boys who go on fourth floor, they use the disabled washroom there. Okay, so lift or stairs, you can just take anything. So when you have to go to communals, it's like a very short time. You have to reach it. Even sometimes like our college warden, she prepares us some kind of cakes and like stuff to eat like for free. So we have to run and then they get finished in like just a minute or two. So we take the stairs because lift takes a lot of time. Okay, so we are back at the ground floor, Deha. You exit, so like this is the important TV. Like usually we are having a formal hall dinner soon, so you just have some kind of things. And very important thing, like you get $3.50 to spend on like NC cultural event, like Hong Kong cultural event, and the college sponsors it. So it's a very rich college. If you know how to, then you can get a lot of money from the college authorities. And this is like, again we are going towards the end, and this is the big building as you can see, the big entrance. Yeah, this is a random Morningsider walking to the G block.
Random Bangladeshi.
Yeah, random Bangladeshi. Okay, so this is the place where we enter from, and this is the same place where we are now exiting. And that's it, guys. Thank you for listening to my blah blah blah. But this was all about Morningside and Morningsiders.